So why don't you just come into what's comfy for you? Close your eyes, lean back in your chair. Take a big breath in. Let it out. And again, big inhale. And just take a few moments to drop down into your body from your mind, breathing deeper into your heart center, into your belly, letting the breath take you all the way down into your feet. Feeling the receptiveness of your heart center, of your being. And feeling the love in the room, this big human family, and the non-human entourage that surrounds us with love and honoring as we hear this beautiful message from Kryon.
Greetings, dear ones. I'm Kryon of Magnetic Service. There are those who have not seen this before. You have to readjust the paradigm of your reality to think that such a thing could be. There's always those for the first time. And the question is always the same. What happened to the man in the chair? Where did he go? Is he still there pretending? And this is where we say, and we always do, that it is the discernment of the human being that is going to make that choice. And there are those who will always say, it cannot be. This is not the way God works. Or is it? It is not the way you were taught God works. What if this is the way God works and Spirit and the Creator are connected to you directly? And that such a thing of channeling is doable and possible and always has been? That every single human being has this ability not to speak to groups, to literally pull in that which is sacred from their own biology. Pull it in. And once you start adjusting to the possibility this could be real, that what you see is the casualness of the message is my partner practicing with me for over 2 decades. The messages are multidimensional, given to him in a way where he has to put his filters aside. And the stream of consciousness, which you call language and sentences, is his. But it represents that which is me from the creating source. In all of the times that we have been in front of you, you're in an energy now where we ask you to pay attention. Number one. We know who is here in the room. We know who is listening. And I have a statement, and there are some of you who need to hear this. Everything that's going on is on purpose. There is no accident. There is no confusion. There is no puzzlement with God. The only puzzlement is with you. If you haven't found that special place yet, we invite you to. The place is only findable with surrender to the human paradigm. What does your logic say about what's happening? You'll say, well, I'll judge it later. No, do it now. Is this real or is it not real? If it's real, then pay attention. That means the Creator knows you. What you've been missing is that whole section that there's more to life than you think. Did you know that all humanity believes in the afterlife? You come in with it. You open your eyes with it. As soon as you are able to think for yourself, you look for the Creator. This is common to humans. What if the Creator is inside? Yes, the Creator is in Gaia and all these other places that you feel it. And you do. But the primary place, if you want to say place, that you will find spirituality is in humanity, in every single human. There is a compassion quotient that is starting to increase. The quotient is that puzzle between light and dark. Light is starting to win. Compassion is starting to come out. It's confusing to some. Some have lived their whole life, and now they're just awakening, and it's uncomfortable. They don't know what they're awakening to. You know why it's so uncomfortable? Because you've blocked spirit all your life. You're good at it. And you know who I'm talking to. You're good at it. You went everywhere else but home. And now you're sitting, and I'm telling you, home has come to you. God inside is the real you, the higher self. It's most of you. It's in every single cell. I want you to relax. This is a safe place, a real safe place. We're not asking you to do anything. I don't want you to join anything, say anything, and I want you to stand up. I just want you to sit there and feel loved and know there is so much more in you than you think. This is the theme, and always has been, of Kryon, but these new energies are starting to promote light. The older energies, all I did, seemingly, the whole time, was to help you to endure the darkness. And now suddenly, I want you to create light. This is who you are. Totally who you are. And if you're having trouble with it, it's because your filter of training, a reality, your paradigm, your truth is getting in the way. What were you taught? How were you taught it? Were you taught this can't happen? Does that mean it can't, or is that just the way your teacher said it was? I want you to look at this and feel it. What is your reality at the moment? Is the man in the chair connected to the other side of the veil or not? We've said it before. If you want to know whether channeling is real, look for the compassion. Look for the love. Spirit will never ask you to do unusual and strange things in order to enhance that which is spiritual. Because you're family. You don't have to work for it, dear ones. And you were told you did. You don't have to work for something that's you and inside you and always has been. All you have to do is acknowledge it and look for it. And then the work begins. The work of a compassionate human being more master-like, more compassionate. That is the message of Kryon. And that is this short message. We'll be back. And so it is.